may hudto kay natong tinen. My dear friends, as we are nearing the Holy Week, in reflecting of the Paschal mysteries of our Lord, we continue to go deeper into our knowledge and our understanding of who God is, of what it means to have a God. Here in our readings today, though similar in many ways, in many account, these stories show to us that God is indeed a God of mercy and compassion. He is not quick in condemning, but quick in His response to show mercy and forgiveness. And He is also a God who will always listen to the woes of the poor and the unjustly treated. It is because in the both stories, from the first reading from the book of Daniel and the gospel story from the gospel according to John, we are told about these women who have been accused by adultery. Susanna was falsely accused by adultery, and God spares her, and God shows to her His compassion. Ang Ginoo maminaw gayud sa mga tao nga gidaogdaog og sa mga tao nga giakusahan nga dili gayud tinuod. And in the gospel story, another case of adultery caught in the act. With this one, Jesus shows mercy and compassion by telling us that He is not quick to condemn. However, in the gospel story, this is made in order to trap the Lord. When He would say, yes, you have to stone this woman because she was caught in adultery and as mandated by the law of Moses. But if He would say no, then He would become a violator to the law of Moses. But if Jesus would say, yes, stone her according to the mandates of the law, then all His preachings on mercy and compassion would be meaningless. Then therefore it is a trap. So also with us, whenever we are at sin, it is also a trap to us. Luring to the allurements and the pleasures of sin, and yet our conscience are tired because we know we are at fault. But there is no way for us to get out, but only in Jesus. Ug mausad kini ang nakit-an nato sa to Ebanghelyo, kung bisan asa si Kristo mutubag, there is no way for Him to get out of the trap. That is why He turned the story upside down, from the externalities of the mandates of the law to the interiority of our conscience. Nga atong konsensya mo'y nahimo natong huwis, mo'y nahimo natong judge, o gado nato'y joke nga sugilanon, nga no kunong nag-iyahay o panglakaw ang mga lalaki. Kay gisuwat ni Kristo ang mga suki nini maong bayhana. O ilang nakitan ang ilangan, muna nagkarakara silag panagan. Nagingon sila, matay, may bawaan man ta. No? And therefore, it is their conscience that made them to be the judge. And it is the mercy of God that would invite us once again to the compassion of the Lord. And as we continue to reflect upon this fifth week of the Lent, and as we are nearing to enter the Passion of our Lord in the Paschal mystery, we continue to behold God's mercy and compassion, that neither Him will condemn us, just like what He did to this woman in our gospel today. But He shows to us the loving and the transformative mercy and forgiveness of God upon us. Amen.